Welcome back, Vintage Gamers, to the first of a few. All will be one Phyrexia brews. So, new set has released on Magic Online, and in its commander set, a couple of interesting cards to build around. I would say there are unlikely to be any crazy staples, except for maybe one. And we'll talk about that at some point. But I have a bunch of brews lined up for you. You can see on the side of the screen here. Blue Pond, Tyvar Hermit, Tyvar Cradle, Atroxa, Natural Order Show and Tell, and Spell Dancer Xerox are the first five things that I've come up with for your entertainment purposes. I will note that some of these decks have not tested very well. But we're going to do our best to make these new cards shine. And shells that make sense. So the very first one that I want to do is Hermit Druid. Hermit Druid is a classic vintage combo deck. Hermit Druid, the card, is banned in Legacy. And it has not seen play for many years. The classic Hermit Druid combo is actually... basically, you don't put a basic land in your deck. So when you activate Hermit Druid, you mill over your entire deck. The combo that for the most part, the most recent combo that I've done with Hermit Druid is you play Narcomoebas and Dread Return and Thassa's Oracle. So you mill over your deck, bring your Narcomoebas into play, and then Dread Return and Thassa's Oracle. The big problem with that is it requires a lot of deck slots. So you have to play, you know, three or four Narcomoebas, or you have to play like some amount of Cabal Therapies and Dread Returns, and you end up with a bunch of cards that are not very good in a vacuum. They're only really good because of the combo, and then you draw them, and you get very mad that you've drawn them. You also expose yourself to things like Force of Negation and Flusterstorm. You kind of are priced into playing like the double Cabal Therapy package so that you don't end up getting your Dread Return Force of Negation or Flusterstorm. And overall, the last Hermit Druid video I did... I was actually siding out the Narcomoeba Dread Return package in post-board games anyways, because people are just bringing in tons and tons of graveyard hate. And so what I did in those old videos is I actually played four Thassa's Oracle, because if you just put an Oracle into play, trigger on the stack, activate your Druid, you accomplish the same thing, but you don't have to, you don't die to graveyard hate. Accomplish the same thing is not exactly true, because you have to have a second card, so now it is actually a two-card combo instead of, you know, a pseudo one-card combo. But you do dodge graveyard hate. So, I have a Hermit Druid deck. Divining Witch is a demonic consultation on a stick. It functions as additional Hermit Druids. So we do have our demonic consultation combo with our Thassa's Oracle. That will win us the game. We have Hermit Druid with Thassa's Oracle. That will win us the game. We've got Witch with Oracle, that will win us the game. And then, of course, we get to our new card, Tyvar Jubilant Brawler, which has some great synergy with a lot of the things that are happening in this deck. So, its static ability is activated abilities of creatures you control have haste. So that's very important with Hermit Druid. Hermit Druid, you know, is a card that really... is hampered by the fact that it is a creature. It is summoning stick. You have to pass the turn with this in play and hope it doesn't get removed or disrupted somehow. So Tyvar allows our Hermit Druid to have, use its ability the minute it comes out. It also has plus untap a creature. That one is not as relevant, but it's, you know, a nice little plus ability. You can untap a mana dork. And then it's actually probably the best ability on Tyvar is its minus two, which mills three cards and then return a creature with mana value two or less to the battlefield. So now that does a couple things. You can, you know, rebuy Hermit Druids that have been countered. You can rebuy witches that have been countered. You can, you know, but the biggest thing is Tyvar actually acts as a Dread Return. So what you can do is you can activate your Hermit Druid, mill over your library, and then minus two, mill three more cards, and return your Thassa's Oracle. So Tyvar acts as a pseudo Dread Return here, Which is like very, very powerful. So something like going turn one, Birds of Paradise, turn two, Tyvar, you know, untap your Birds of Paradise. And then on turn three, play a Oracle, a Hermit Druid with haste, activate, and then bring back your Oracle. That is a winning combination. So that is why I wanted to try Tyvar in this vintage deck. I feel like it may be something that gives a boost to a very underrepresented archetype, and we'll see what happens. Obviously, someone is going to ask, why do you have Birds of Paradise in Vintage? And the reason is, I tried Deathrite Shaman, and it was really, really bad. I had a hard time making enough mana with Deathrite Shaman, having enough fetches to use from the graveyard. I don't know if that's a function of the format recently, you know, being mono-white heavy. So mono-white is not a deck that plays fetch lands. But my Deathrite Shamans were very, very bad, and I wanted to make sure that this always made mana. It also works a little bit better with Tyvar's untap ability. Deathrite Shaman having to eat two lands to make two mana was something that came up a lot. So what we're going to do tonight is try Birds of Paradise instead of Deathrite Shaman. It might just be really bad, but it's what I wanted to try. The mana base is horrible, and that's a function of the fact that I can't play a basic land in my deck due to Hermit Druid. So I get wastelanded out of games very, very often. We have a ton of non-basics dual lands to fetch up so that we can, you know, hopefully not get mana screwed. But we are on 16 lands with 4 Moxen, 4 Birds, and 4 Preordains. I hope that's enough. I've had some troubles in my most recent leagues with that. In the sideboard, we've got a ton of removal because I found Mono White to be a very, very bad matchup. They remove your creature and kill you really quickly. And I also put a Loam in there to help us with the land issue. You do have access to Vigors and Oofs. And of course, we're playing all the broken blue cards so that hopefully we can force things and not die. That was a long deck intro, but I think it was worth explaining because this is kind of a niche combo deck. And if you don't know about Vintage, you probably haven't seen it. So, on with the league. If you'd like to see your deck played on this channel, check out the Patreon link in the description below where you can find all the information you need to submit a donation deck list. Let's battle. Okay, here we go. Round one with our Hermit Druid Tyvar deck. What do we have? I've got a Birds of Paradise into a Tyvar with Demonic and Fluster. That seems pretty reasonable. Also, this Birds art is great, so there's that. But yeah, I don't know. So like the last time I played Hermit Druid, I really thought it was pretty good. I played a Lurrus deck with Living Wish, and I felt like it was pretty close to the necessary power level to compete in the format. I have now just realized that I'm not able to cast Birds of Paradise off of Underground Sea like I was Deathrite Shaman, and that may be an issue. That could be a problem. Yeah, we need to this mana base should have a Bayou in it. So I had the mana base as all islands because I was playing Gush. I guess I am still playing Gush. I was playing Mystic Sanctuary, but the mana was so bad. And the mana is really bad because your combo is theoretically blue-blue-green to complete. It's blue-blue-green, and I have black cards in my deck. So, not ideal. Uh-oh. We've got an Ancient Tomb Black Lotus. Sapphire, are we getting killed by Jewel Shops on turn one? Yeah, we are. Okay. Well, you know, chat... YouTube viewers aren't going to see this, but before we played this match, I actually played a 5-0 match with a deck I was testing in a league, and we got just absolutely destroyed by turn one Jewel Shops in both games. And it looks like we are going to once again lose to Jewel Shops on turn one. I really don't think this deck is reasonable, but... The good news is, unlike Initiative, my Birds of Paradise can steal Coveted Jewel. Because it doesn't need to deal damage, it just needs to be not blocked. But yeah, we're not getting a turn, so there's no point in continuing this game. So, alright, didn't keep Force of Will and died. right. Well, the good news is I have access to Force of Vigor, Force of Negation, Collector Oof. So we have some answers here. I'm going to take Tyvar out in this matchup. Tyvar is really good at giving us redundancy and helping us grind, but it's not very good at stopping an opponent's combo deck. So we're actually going to take the card out in this instance, focus on our combo and stopping the opponent's combo. And I'm going to take out I think I can get away with taking out a land and maybe a bird. Let's try that. All right, so this hand is a turn 3 kill with a Vigor and a Besage You and a Brainstorm into a Force of Will. It's probably fine. I don't know. It's not like the strongest anti-combo hand, but it has some good elements, and Brainstorm looks okay here. Let's see if we get turn 1'd again. If we get turn 1'd again, that will be the sixth straight game of being turn 1'd. Ooh. Okay, that's okay. I don't really want to make any choices right now. I think we can wait until my opponent's upkeep. Maybe find a, you know, different green card to pitch. And it's kind of unlikely for my opponent to hit cards they can cast off of Forge here. It's just Moxen, really. So they would have to get a lucky set of, like, Moxen into... I didn't cast Brainstorm. Okay. All right, well, we drew the green card anyways, so everything is fine, I guess. Oh, man. I don't know. This is my life. I'm hoping they'll force this if they want to force something, because if they force my Force of Vigor, I will probably losing. Okay, so we got a force out of their hand. I think that's a good thing for us. We're going to go untap, and we're going to Vigor their Forge and their Ruby, which will leave them on 2 mana and a mana vault and 2 cards in hand. So I think I'm in a decent spot. Got another Metamorph off their top. The problem is I didn't cast my Brainstorm, so I lost the ability to fetch, which is not great. But they're out of stuff, so that's good. All right. So the problem with Witch is Witch Oracle is a 5-mana combo, or sorry, a 4-mana combo that requires black, blue, blue. And I guess if we draw a land, we can do that. So I'm going to probably play this Besage You, which might be a little bit on the risky side of things, and attempt to possibly combo off on the next turn. We also need to make sure we have a card in hand to discard. So this works just like Demonic Consultation Oracle. Put the Oracle into play, trigger out in the stack, name a card not in my deck, mill over my deck. All right, so I am going to cast this Brainstorm to try to get one card deeper here. And we're looking to find a land that makes blue or black. Yeah, that'll do it. All right, so if my opponent doesn't have Force of Will, or they don't know the combo, then we have an avenue here to win the game. So we're going to go blue, blue, Thassa's Oracle, any resolvers. Yep, and then activate with the Oracle on the stack, pitching the Emerald, and naming Abandon Hope. Break Magic online, and then win the game. All right. So we got one back from Jewel Shops. That's nice. will sure help my confidence, as I've been quite shattered by the recent matchups. All right, let's go run it back. I don't really think that we have, you know, we have a pretty solid amount of counter magic, really. We have six forces of blue forces, two green forces, two collector oofs, two fluster storms. So we have a lot of, you know, and a Besaidu, plus a bunch of, you know, pretty redundant combo. So. Yeah, yeah, we can, we have plenty of time to name good things. I have a Life from the Loam in the board because I my deck cannot contain basic lands, and I've been wastelanded way too many times in the last 2 days. I think I've lost a large majority of my matches with this deck due to mana issues, which is why we're not playing Deathrite Shaman anymore. Which just feels weird, but... So I have a Vigor, and I have a Misstep, and I have... like really fast mana. I can't imagine not keeping this hand. Again, I would really like to keep a hand with Force of Will or Negation, but... All right, so I did not get turn one killed. This is a good sign. Looking for... That's an interesting one. Ah, man. Maybe the answer here is just to pass and hold open everything. I don't know. We could... We don't actually have very good mana here to like play Hermit Druid Consort and Ancestral. Huh. Yeah, I think what I'll do is play my Lotus and pass. It's quite possible I'm pitch Hermit Druid to Vigor this game and look for an Oracle to do Demonic Consultation Oracle. Okay, that's five mana. I think I'll just fetch an Underground Sea and cast Ancestral. Okay. There's a lot of mana in this deck, even though I boarded one out. But... see what happens. Collector oof. Interesting. All right, well, let's look at their hand. PO, Force, Jewel, Ottawara, Workshop, Metamorph, and we drew another land. This is really bad. This is super bad. Maybe we play Collector Oof and Consult for Force of Will. This feels like the line that makes the most sense. So I have five mana, so I can actually play Collector Roof and Hermit Druid as well. So yeah, I think that's the line that makes the most sense. Force pitching PO. Consult. Sure hope we don't die. this time we're going to name Force of Will. Let's see what happens. All right. So six cards were exiled, and then Force of Will was immediately on top. We're going to force their force. This resolves a collector roof for us, which is quite good. And then we're also going to resolve a Hermit Druid, because if we draw an Oracle, we do win the game next turn. All right, so my opponent is on Ancient Tomb, Mishra's Workshop, and they have access to Jewel, Metamorph, and Otawara. Black Lotus is not a good draw for them. So then the question is, do they play Jewel? That probably does not work well for them either, because they won't have a land drop, so they won't be able to, like, Otawara or anything. They're going to play Jewel. Okay. I'm a little surprised by that. We can attack with our Collector Roof and steal the Jewel. Playing Jewel there does not feel like a good play to me. All right, well, now it's my Jewel. I do think I am going to gush. Even though it's a really bad gush, I have so many draws. I have four draws that just win the game on the spot. No, I shouldn't gush. There's no reason to gush. Well, if my opponent draws Island and Odawara's me, I can't counter Odawara. And then they play Metamorph on Jewel, and I actually can't counter Metamorph either. And I don't have a green card to vigor a Jewel in response. So I actually think I am going to. Interesting. Not the best gush here. This is why I don't really like Flusterstorm against them, but... Alright, we hit both green card and we hit Oracle. So this is good. So now we can go blue, Oracle, trigger on the stack, activate Hermit Druid. And win the game. Okay, all right. Okay. Not bad. Okay, round two. We're up against the Prince. Very strong player. This is a good hand. Fast mana, Tyvar, cantrips, misstep. I guess misstep is not very good against a variety of the shops decks that Prince plays, but they have quite the range, so we'll have to see. Prelims are only 200 play points now. I actually really like the current prelim structure. Wow, that's a hard choice. Oh, wow. I really would like this bird. I guess I just don't need a bird in this matchup, or in this match with the current mana situation. I'm going to not expose myself to Wasteland, and I'm going to hold open Misstep and Force is what I'm going to do. What's what I'm going to do here? It's likely that if I have no, you know, okay, rewarded. It's likely that if I have no, like, apparent play with Tyvar, what I normally do is plus once on nothing. Oh, it's PO, so it's Jewel Shops again, probably. And then I'll start, like, minus two for value. Just try to find something off of it. Yeah, all right, so Jewel Shops again. Not great for the home team. Wait, I didn't fetch. I thought I bottomed a bird. I definitely bottomed a bird. Well, the bird makes two mana next turn, so. Or I guess it makes one mana. Lovely. All right, well. Time to find out if my opponent has Workshop Jewel, because that would be on brand for this current start. They don't have Workshop Jewel. I don't think we're in a terrible spot. But, I had Misstep Force and they had Ancestral Force, so we'll see what happens. All right, that's a good sign. All right, passing back. So let's see what we draw here. I don't have double green, so I don't actually have a Hermit Druid kill. I have many birds. I think I'm going to minus and see if we can hit a Hermit Druid. I hit an Oracle. The Oracle is fine because we have so many Oracles in our deck. It's not a huge deal to do a little scry life. Another Oracle. All right, well, I don't want any of those on top, and I'm going to play a Birds of Paradise. All right, well, time to find out if my opponent now has a jewel. The good news is if we get a turn and we top deck a Druid, we do win. The bad news is we're probably dead. You're right. I could have made a second bird. I just didn't. Because I was not thinking about it. But they have a jewel, so. I was just trying to get the game over with faster, you know? You're right. So it's really weird because I don't think it highlights in the way I would have expected it to. Is this going to be a PO? Well, that's a top. Okay, are we maybe stealing a jewel? That'd be nice. Ooh, no, that means they could still PO me. Odawara bounced my jewel. Wow. All right, well, Hermit Druid is a win. That's not a Hermit Druid. If I had played my Birds of Paradise last turn. Oh no, I can tap my bird. And play a bird. All right, I'm saved. I thought the misplay might have killed me, but now I can untap my bird and play force. Perfect. I'm sure that will win the game. good lord. At least they're beautiful and tropical and bird-like. All right, here's a jewel. Here's a force with all of my bird mana. Hasty bird, Tyvar putting in work. All right, come on, baby. Can I just get a Hermit Druid? Would a witch work? A witch wouldn't work, right? What if I witch for a Hermit Druid? No, still wouldn't work. Witch, I don't have a thing to activate. A gush is a great draw. Blue gush. Well, maybe we do blue green gush. Green blue gush. Gush is a good draw. Any Hermit Druids? Oh, hello. So I don't know if it matters, but I can hold priority, activate Tyvar, and then do it. Does anyone know if that has any effect on anything? Or is it worse or better? I like doing it because it's fun, but I don't know if it actually matters at all. All right, Tyvar actually doing the work here. Tyvar gave us a hasty top deck druid into a dread return oracle kill. That's a one Phyrexia new card in vintage getting the W. Go Birds of Paradise, by the way. All right, okay. Wait, maybe I just need to stream all my leagues. Chat is lucky. Chat lets me absorb some luck. Okay. That's good. All right. Collector, oof. Vigor, negation. Now I'm questioning whether I'm supposed to actually be boarding this Tyvar out. So one thing that's like kind of annoying slash problematic is decks like to bring in a lot of graveyard hate, which doesn't really make sense because my main combo doesn't use the graveyard, but Tyvar uses the graveyard. So it's a little, I don't know. I like to board out the Tyvar because I don't want it to, like, I don't want to get Ley Line of the Voided and have this card be pretty blank, but I think I'm going to go with the same plan as last time and board Tyvar, land, and bird out and keep our, you know, combo-oriented controlling, a controlling combo deck here. I think that's my plan. I like that idea. Okay, this is like exactly what we're going for, right? We got a force, we've got fast mana, we've got a witch. Just need to draw an oracle, and then we have a turn to kill. Yep, that's a mana crypt. That's an academy, is a tinker. Time walk, okay. Really not at liberty to counter anything other than payoff spells. All right, turn two, it's not, turn one jewel, really. So could they have force backup for their jewel? Survey says no. Not as lucky as Jose. All right, show me your hand. Do you have another jewel? Pio Pio Saga. Interesting. Well, drawing a land there is not great. But we have four outs in the top of our deck. So, see what happens. They only have one Pio target currently, so that's not too bad. If they top deck another Moxen or something, then it gets a lot worse. Because Pio for two is getting close to... Yeah, okay. All right, well, time to find out how bad this goes for us. This is divination. Well, I guess it's not divination when it costs one blue. So one blue, draw two. And then they make enough mana to play their second one, which would be one blue, draw two. Okay, two blue, draw four. Still pretty good. Okay. Do we live another day? We live another day. I think I can just get a tropical here. All right, I'm looking for one of my four oracles off the top. That's a Flooded Strand. So we do have the option to witch into something. So we can end of turn witch for an oracle. We have two collector oofs. I don't think we want to wish for a collector oof. I don't think it's going to stop our opponent. I think I'm just going to pass and... I don't have one mana counter spells, though. This is unfortunate. They just have a jewel. Hmm. Well, because Syndrome is worried about us getting a turn, which I think is fair. I don't know how likely we are to get a turn. I don't have any counters that counter this, though, so it doesn't really make a difference. There's also... I also don't have any counters for this. So I guess we're gonna die. Think I have any counterplay at this point in the, now because I don't have access to Vigor because I don't have another green card. I just drew too many lands this game, right? I drew Turn one land, turn two land, probe was a land. Did I draw three lands? Might have drawn three lands. No, I might have drawn probe and two lands or something. I don't think I have any outs to this, so. Yeah. One Oracle, one down. Yeah, so like obviously the only, you know, the like the only play I can make there beside, I can make two plays. I can make end of turn witch for an Oracle and then untap Oracle, kill them. Or I can witch for an oof. I hope it's not in a really bad spot, or mill all my Oracles or mill all my oofs. And then I have to put two of my mana away, which puts me extremely far away from winning. Not extremely far away, I guess, because I have land. I would have one land in my hand, so I would actually be one land and a Oracle and a card away from winning, which is kind of asking for a lot. I don't think I like going for oof there. I think I would rather try to go for the win, but it's certainly an option. This hand does not have mana. This hand has... Yeah, that was the other thing I was concerned about, where oof doesn't exactly automatically make that a win either. All right, well, I'm going to keep this hand. Obviously, there's a lot that has to go right for this hand to be good, but I think it makes sense. Maybe it doesn't. But it gives me some good looks here, a blind look and a preordain for things like collector oof. See what they have. Trinisphere, Demonic. Well, that's a pretty anemic hand. They have turn one Trinisphere, but I had Time Walk. Ancestral and extra fast mana. I mean, I've drawn pretty well so far. Oh, I guess this should not have used my... Oh, I guess it doesn't matter because I drew a fetch. I think I would rather play Witch than Druid. Both will still win me the game. All right. Can't cast Demonic Tutor, so they were banking pretty heavily on Trinisphere being good. So this is exactly what I'm talking about, chat. They boarded in Tormod's Crypt, but my combo does not use the graveyard at all right now. So this is what I was trying to avoid. I was trying to avoid having to deal with Tormod's Crypt and those kind of effects. So I feel really good about boarding out Tyvar. Needle was a good draw from them, because now they can name Witch, but we have follow-up Druid. Okay, so Lucard is our best draw, and then... And then, yeah, I guess we'll just play everything. Okay, I'm just looking for oracles now. All right, so obviously they're not gonna play Trinisphere at this point. They're gonna make some Saga tokens. We have things to block Saga tokens for a pretty long time. They could have a second Needle in their deck, though, which would be pretty rough. Basically, just looking for cantrips and oracles. Misstep would have been great the turn they played the Needle. Yeah, that is an illegal play. -1 points for you. See how it is not highlighted right now when I have the ability to activate things? That would be because I cannot activate it. So So I'm still pretty worried about this game. My opponent has double Saga, and the clock is quite fast because they had a lot of zero drops and one drops. They drew another one drop, right? So we could definitely lose the Saga tokens this game if we don't get to our combo fast enough. I can't imagine that I'm supposed to force this. Actually, maybe it's a good use of our mana. All right, so I take 6 and I go to 11. And I'm just looking, again, I'm just looking for cantrips, tutors, and Thassa's Oracles. And I have like a turn or two left to draw them. I don't have very many turns though. This is Dismember? Wow. My opponent drew Dismember. That's quite good. Now we're going to be asking for a lot. Seeing as we've already used Ancestral. I didn't include like Yogwill in this deck either. Not that that would be good against Tormod Crypt anyways. I just drew all the wrong cards in all the wrong order here. I think it looks like a loss for us. Our opponent just drew much better than we did. Even though I can't really say that because I cast Ancestral Recall in this game. I guess I can't say that. But opponent drawing Needle Dismember as their two draw steps was certainly an issue. I am going to counter this just in case I can like cantrip off somehow. But yeah, we are super, super dead here. I didn't bring in Vigor. Oh, I know I have Vigor, so I want to keep Witch in play in case I draw Vigor. But I don't know what that's going to do. Yeah, we just didn't draw the right cards. We drew a lot of cards, but we didn't draw the right cards. I did draw Vigor. Does that actually save me, though? Doesn't actually save me. Because I can Vigor two constructs, block a construct. It buys me another turn. I guess we should do that. I'm still going to have to draw multiple creatures, and I don't have the ability to time walk. Man, this is a really rough way to lose. We actually lost to, like, Saga Gaming. I don't think Saga Gaming would have been good enough if my opponent didn't top deck Needle, though. Oh, they do have Key. Yeah. I should have waited then. My bad. I didn't want to give them the ability to draw Force, but I knew they had Trinisphere, so there was really no point in doing that. Yeah, the Needle was on our Witch. They didn't have Needle in their probe hand, and then they drew Needle. And then we drew Mental Misstep, of course. Yeah, I mean, that's bad beats. All right, round 3. Let's see what we can do with... Yeah, that's a hand. It's rough to look at these like Hermit Druids and Witches and not have off-color Moxen to cast them on turn 1. But the reality of the situation is because I'm going for like 4 Oracle, my main combo costs blue-blue-green. And so it's really impossible to be playing like a bunch of off-color Moxen in this deck. I am going to cast this Ancestral on their upkeep. Could theoretically, if I had a second land, there's a chance I would wait for Flusterstorm backup, but I think it makes the most sense to do this now. All right, so we have our combo. We are on track to combo on turn... we need another land. Oh, we have a Gush, actually. So we are technically on track to combo on turn 3. Don't have Force backup right now, which is something I would like to have. My opponent has a lot of Moxen. Ooh. That is unfortunate. I had a Beef Bowl. It's quite good. Yeah, I can't mental misstep this because it would be countered by the Lavinia. Yeah, everything here is quite bad for me. I still think... I am going to walk. I'd like to get mana, and this is the best way for me to get mana. Gush, even though it's countered... Oh, actually, I guess I can't cast it. Never mind. I was like, if it was countered, I could still pick up my thing. That's a great draw. That's a fantastic draw. So if my opponent is on PO, it's actually better for me to just play Hermit Druid and hold up Fluster. Yeah, it's probably worth it. If we can make it to their end step, I may brainstorm even with using the fetch land, just so that I have a high chance of having extra mana. Wing places? No, I don't know any good wing places, even in anywhere near me, so I'd love there to be a good wing place. All right, what you got for me, homie? Teferi? Mentor. Don't care about Mentor. Ancestral. So... Now, this is interesting. I think we're just guaranteed to win if we Flusterstorm this, right? Because they only have one card in hand. I guess that's not true. They have a top. They could draw into force blue card. I'm just like worried that if I misstep this, they could also have misstep. And I'm not guaranteed to have four mana for my combo next turn for Flusterstorm protection anyways. This could be wrong, and I could be convinced that this is wrong. Because if I were to hit a land drop, I could play Oracle combo with Flusterstorm backup. In fact, if I had a land drop, I would probably misstep instead. All right, so time to jam. Make sure I tap my mana right. I'm gonna play an Oracle, and I'm gonna Hermit Druid. So here's another instance, chat, where Dread Return would be really bad. So Dread Return would get countered by Lavinia. So just another example of the things I was worried about with the Dread Return aspect of the Hermit Druid combo. Okay, so my opponent has only shown us Lavinia, Top, Mentor, Tundra, Moxen. So they could still be Esper Pio, or they could be Esper Tinker. And inside of Esper Pio, they could have Sagas or not have Sagas. I think in general, all three of those decks, I'm going to still want Collector of Invigor. It's just Vigor will be more useful against decks that have Saga. And then I do want Negation. So I'm boarding in basically the same stuff I boarded in for Jewel Shops, even though the matchup is a little less volatile than that. I don't think I want to board in answers to Lavinia. It doesn't seem like we're fighting on the right axis if we do that. I don't know if this time I would actually want to board all my Tyvars out. Maybe I'll board two of my Tyvars out. I think I'm gonna do the same, a pretty similar thing to last time. It's just that these cards are just much worse when my opponent is trying to combo, and we need to try to stop them. I think in general, we would be the deck that is, you know, because they're a faster combo deck than us, it's on us to be more controlling. I mean, maybe this is crazy. That's a lot of... It's a lot of birds coming out, but I don't think I need birds as much in this kind of matchup. Could be wrong. Let's find out. So far, actually, the Hermit Druid aspects of this deck have performed pretty well, right? I would say so. Obviously, the key cards have been forces, but The combo has been castable. We haven't been wastelanded, I guess, is the big difference. We've played against three Tinker decks in this league, and my last league I played with Hermit Druid, I think I played against four Wasteland decks. So, all right, well, show me your secrets. What do you got for me? My opponent is on, a nice dress-down paradoxical deck. Where could they have come up with that idea? Dress down is an absolute problem. Dress down is a problem. But the good news is I'm not playing Dread Return where I would lose the game if they dress down. In this case, I simply don't get my Oracle. I'm really interested in turning this Ponder into mana sources. Those are multiple mana sources, and then we can get rid of this witch before it matters. I like the opponent's deck, though, you know. PO Dressdown seems pretty good. They do have the Mental Misstep for my Demonic Consultation. This is a Demonic Tutor. So I don't have a black mana currently for Demonic Consultation, and I don't want to draw a witch. So what I'm going to do is cast Merchant Scroll. Now, that means that we have only Oracle, well, not only Oracle, but kind of have Oracle to pitch to force. Oh, what did they draw? Fluster? Well, that's a nightmare. But the good news is because we have four Oracles, we're okay with pitching Oracles to force. Yeah, that was a really good draw from them. We are super far behind now. Not super far behind, I guess, because we do still have Oracle Hermit, but we just have no way to interact with their interaction. They still have Tinker Demonic. They have a really strong hand. All they really need is a Mox of some kind. And then they're in a really good spot. It's a good hand. If they had a force in it, it's probably like pretty close to one of your best hands. All right, so this is Demonic. I don't think I am allowed to counter that. It's Demonic. Demonic, Dress Down, PO, Tinker, Misstep. Okay, so now we're forced to draw our witch, which is a terrible draw. It's a black card, and I can't cast black cards. I have no idea what they're going to DT for. I think I'm going to hold my Besieger, though. I think I'm going to hold everything. I have no forward momentum, so I think I'm just going to go enter defensive position here. I'm not happy about it, because I thought we had a pretty powerful explosive hand, considering we had our consultation and our oracle, but they're just going to pass back. Okay. I don't really like how this is going. I'd like to hit a fetch land would be great. A Birds of Paradise. All right, well. I think we're playing our Besieger now. I am going to hold the Hermit Druid, though, because I think it's very likely I might need forces, both forces. My opponent didn't misstep my Birds of Paradise, which I think is interesting. Are they going to cycle a dress down? Oh, they Demonic for Ancestral. Fair. I actually kind of like forcing here. Obviously, I lose out on my combo aspects, but my opponent has PO with no blue card or no artifacts, Tinker with no artifacts, Mental Misstep, and Dress Down. Like, if they want a cantrip Dress Down, so they can maybe untap and PO it, but they're a little on the rough side. They didn't choose to cantrip Dress Down. I think if I had known I would have a mana, which I don't have a mana, then I might do dress down. But then I can't hold it open. I don't think they need to hold it open right now, though. All right, the good news is that our Birds of Paradise now makes us black mana. So I am going to cast a witch. I'm also going to cast a Hermit Druid, so. I am one mana short of being able to witch for an oracle, play an oracle, and activate Hermit Druid. Not that that play would work through a dress down. They drew a needle. Okay. It's a weird needle art. Freaky. So I assume they're going to name Druid. That's fine with me. And then they're going to draw a land and play Tinker. And they're going to Tinker the Needle away. Again, this is fine with me. I know three of the four cards in their hand. So I have a pretty good chance of killing the Citadel. They would have to have a Fluster or a Force on top or have drawn a Force. They drew a Force for turn. Okay. Well, drawing Force for turn there is really bad for me. It's really, really bad for me. All right, well, now they're deterministic, so let's get the heck out of here. My opponent had the good cards. They just didn't have Moxen, so they were a little constrained on what they were capable of doing, but they had, like, all the nice restricted cards, so. I would have liked to play that game more aggressively because my opponent didn't have a Force for the first, you know, 6 or 7 turns of the game, but I just didn't have the requisite resources to pull off aggressive plays. Dress down is so good. I mean, I don't think we were ever stopped by dress down, but we would have been. Wow, that's a hand. I think this is an ancestral hand. Like I cast ancestral instead of casting any of these other choices. Maybe I can cast Druid. If I cast Druid, then any fetch land or any land is a kill, but doesn't have protection. No, I don't think I had the right mana colors, right? I can't remember. I think I'm going to cast Ancestral here, which may be wrong, but see what happens. My opponent thanked me and then said, except for doing that. All right, well, show me your secrets. I didn't draw any forces. My opponent has a very, a very disruptive hand. They have Swords, Lavinia, Needle, Ruby, Probe, PO, Land. So, unfortunately, my Hermit Druid is going to get probed and needled here. Which, I guess that's not a huge deal because I have Besiege You, but that's also my land drop. Things are bad. I was hoping for a little more off that Ancestral, but what I got was a little bit of everything that I already had. Which is kind of the problem with playing these combo decks in Vintage, where you have a lot of combo pieces. It's not Legacy, so I can't like brainstorm them back, you know? I think it's required for me to try to find a land here. think I'm going to bottom. Both. Sweet. Time to deploy some Hermit Druids. So we have Besage, uncounterable way to stop this needle. So my opponent might still be forced to swords my Hermit Druids. Oh, they drew Merchant. Merchant Ancestral. Seems good. So we can draw like Black Lotus and we would win the game if they had no counter magic. Oh, we're getting there. Let's go. Oh my God. That was gross. That was just disgusting. Oh, wow. All right, on to round four. Got a Doomsday player across the table. His hand has a little bit too many lands, but I'm not really willing to mulligan it. I think if we draw a blue card, play a turn one Hermit Druid, I'll be pretty happy. Oh, that's a Bazaar of Baghdad. That is not a Doomsday. Am I still happy? No. Oh, it's Squee, even worse. Well, so here's what we're going to do, chat. We're going to top deck a blue card, resolve our Hermit Druid, and then top deck a Thassa's Oracle. That is step one. That is actually the harder of the two steps, but it doesn't help me resolve my Hermit Druid, so it's kind of a problem. Resolvers. All right. So now we need our Hermit Druid not to be furied. And then we need to draw a blue card and not get wastelanded. And then we win. That seems like a small number of asks, right? Just ask for the little bits. Nothing crazy. Oh, they found another Lizard Wizard. All right, so they've got two Master of Deaths, three Lizards, no Hollow Ones, and a Pass the Turn. All right, well, a simple... Oh, they drew Strip Mine. All right, well, that's really bad because now my opponent is going to be drawing way too... Oh my Lord, stop. That's fine, that's fine. Everything's fine. We have to do another turn anyways, so... Blue card? You'd love to see it. All right, we have drawn exactly the cards we need to win this game. The question will be, is it actually enough to beat my freaking Squee opponent here? It looks like it could be. It absolutely looks like it could be. But they are drawing a million cards every turn. That's three Master of Deaths. I think we're there. I think we're there. It can't be a Wasteland anymore. It can't be... Yeah, I think we got it. How many pitch cards this we run? The whole deck. We even drew another Oracle. Wow. I do think we drew, like, probably our best possibles in every circumstance here, so... Can't be very unhappy about this one. In fact, I'm quite happy about this one. Getting a game one win versus Squee. Not easy to do. They have the Force. We have the Force. Do they have the Mindbreak Trap? Wait, this is our second spell? They can't Mindbreak Trap it. Oh my lord, is our... Oh my... Wait, maybe this deck's broken. All right. Leyline of the Void's coming in. Tabernacle's coming in. I don't know if we want to bring in Loam. We could bring in Deluge. Would you bring in Deluge here? Don't know. Oh, we have Loam, Deluge. I don't think Vigor matters. I don't really feel like this is a Gush or a Dig or a Negation. I do think I want Tyvar, but I don't know. Like, if I want three Tyvars, it seems like a lot of Tyvars. Not a misstep matchup. I feel like a Witch. We have a Witch. And then... I hate Vamp. All right, we'll do this. This looks acceptable. Wait, did I actually want to keep Loam? I don't think I actually want Loam. Keep Vamp. Do I want Deluge? I don't think so. It seems kind of bad. All right, let's try this. I mean, if my opponents can draw the best cards, why can't I? All right, is this hand good? New question. I don't know. It's not bad. Let's try it. I feel like we've had a lot of lands, but I like purposely put a ton of lands into my deck because I was getting wastelanded so much yesterday. But maybe it's a really rough right push and pull right now in Vintage, where there are combo decks and there are wasteland decks. Oh no, my opponent accidentally kept a hand that did not have Bazaar Baghdad in it. Well. That is unfortunate. What were we going to draw? That would have been probably the best draw in our deck. So I feel pretty confident about... I like this, actually. I think this game would have gone pretty well. This covers, like, so much. Okay. All right, looks like we'll round five. We're going to wrap this up, this league up, with one more matchup against Bazaar. Should probably be Dredge. Our hand is Black Lotus, Triple Birds of Paradise. That's kind of a beautiful hand that I'm just going to take a quick little snipperino right there. Wait, how do you get... How do you get it to be, like, not chopped off by you, Twitter? Do I have to, like... Do I have to do, like, this and then, like, trim it or something? Twitter's so weird, man. Just show what I want to show. Why you gotta be like this? All right. Done. Easy. I am gonna mulligan this hand for anyone wondering at home. yes, this hand's much better. So I kind of like Tyvar here. I think the answer is just get rid of Flusterstorm because I'm never gonna have a mana window where it's gonna be viable. That's not bizarre. Oh my lord, it's not bizarre, chat. What? Micrograms on not dredge? All right. Well, I have some regrets. So unfortunately, Hermit Druid into Tyvar is not a kill. Because I will not have enough mana. And my opponent probably has access to needles. And I can't demonic into fast mana. I don't have access to vigor in the main. So the answer is end of turn consult for an oracle here. It's a good thing we... I mean, I would have forced their Karn. I don't know if it would have been a bad thing. The problem is I'm just going to get needled, right? Yeah, I don't think I'm going to cast Consult. I think that would be... I mean, this could needle me too. I just don't know if we're going to have the velocity needed to... for this game to go well. I think the way we win this game is if we draw an Oracle and we go Consult Oracle. That feels like the way we would win this game. So I'm going to hold the console and just hope we draw a load of Oracle. Okay, so I assume, so they got a top, so they didn't get a needle from their main, they got a needle from their board. Okay, Hermit Druid has been effectively silenced. Ooh, Mana Crypt is a good draw, that's gonna make them constructs. I think, I still don't know if my opponent is on a blue deck or not. Thassa's Oracle is still a winning line. Okay. I think it's fine for me to preordain a Birds of Paradise and a Tyvar. I think these are both no bueno. I drew a force, but I don't have a blue card. I guess the good news is I could demonic for a blue card. Oh, I'm an idiot. Of course they can make a construct. I was thinking about talking in chat and I just I forgot. Whoops. Oh, my bad, chat. That one's on me. If we lose because we needed to get one more turn through these constructs, it's my bad. I still don't know what kind of deck my opponent is. Okay, so I still don't know what kind of deck my opponent is. Yeah, this Hermit Druid really needed to be blocker. I guess I can Tyvar as a blocker. Tyvar regenerate my Hermit Druid. They have a Lattice coming. All right, well, I would like to draw Thassa's Oracle, please. That's a mental misstep. Not actually Thassa's Oracle. All right, well. Wait, I can hit an Oracle off my Tyvar, though. That doesn't do anything though, right? Yeah, that would work. All right. Any believers in chat? Any believers? That would be a sick way to win. All right, any oracles? Top three? Oracles? Did not hit an oracle. Unfortunate. So unlucky. I did get a Birds of Paradise, though. That's cute. So I can block and force a lattice and then still draw an oracle, so. That would have been really sweet if I just blind hit an oracle and then consult killed. I didn't think about that. All right, here's a lattice. I have a force. Is that good enough? No, they have force backup. That is sad. So we're actually playing jewel shops again? So three jewel shops, an Esper PO, and a dredge? That is the least fun league in existence. I could theoretically demonic for fluster and fluster this so that I would live for a turn. I wouldn't live for a turn because I got the block. Okay, cool. This is the least... Oh, I think our deck is actually, like, nice against Jeskai, though. Okay, it's fine. So it's the same board plan. So... We really did not need Life from the Loam or 16 lands or Birds of Paradise this league, but you know, sometimes it happens like that, I guess. Okay, game two against Jewel Shops. I did not know that Jewel Shops was this common. If you're available to play Vintage Magic the Gathering, there's a prelim happening in 9 minutes. Go sign up for that. Keep. Show me your secrets. Does my deck actually have legs? Nah, I think it has wings, actually. Force, so look at this. They boarded in Surgical Extraction. I love it. Okay, let's get a Birds of Paradise in play. Okay. I have a force, but they also have a force. So if they find a blue card with their top, not ideal. Yeah, I'll probably end up doing the Spell Dancer deck later. I'm probably gonna have to borrow them or something. They're pretty expensive right now. I do have a nice Spell Seeker or Spell Dancer Xerox deck to play though. Okay, Doki, let's do the preordaining. I have a witch and a time walk. I think we'll just cantrip this time walk. Seems reasonable. What's up, no props? All right. I got a druid and a Baseju and a force, which means we are once again on the oracle finding life. I guess I have to force this Might Stone, huh? I didn't really consider that. Do you have a force backup, I guess? I guess they top decked force off the sensei's top. All right, well, I consider that bad for me. I think we're behind a little bit here, chat. We might have an issue. It's okay. Our deck contains Ancestral Recall, and I hear that is a powerful magic card. Yeah, so they have surgically extracted Hermit Druid, which is fine. I'm not super worried about that because we still have access to witches and we still have access to Consult Oracle. So I think that's okay. I am going to play the Baseju out so that my Birds of Paradise can funnel into a Force of Will, which gives me at least something to do. Yeah, I am not willing to counter Time Vault. If they have the follow-up saga, so be it. Ooh! That's a good one. I guess if they have a second Might Stone, but these lists are only playing two Might Stone, which I don't think I like very much. I think if I was to make Jewel Shops, I would probably be playing four Might Stones if I could. I think Might Stone is so good and solves one of the biggest problems of Jewel Shops, which is Collector Roof. All right. I think we're in a decent spot in this game now. Collector Roof was a strong draw. Unfortunately, my Birds of Paradise does not give Exalted, nor does it drain for two damage like a Deathrite Shaman. But it does look pretty, which, you know, that's something. The little oof that could. Any I'm actually oofs in chat? Sorry, friend. That is illegal. No, I specifically cut Deathrite Shaman for Birds of Paradise because I was having major issues with not having enough lands to eat with them. This league, however, I have not faced very many wastelands, so the birds has looked a little silly. Nice chat. All the rainbow badges. 44 months for Ian. Wow. Wow. All right. We have, how many more attacks? Four more attacks. Hey, look, Thassa's Oracle. So, does that speed up my clock? Three attacks or two attacks? Yeah. All right, well, I'm gonna speed up my clock here. I can't hard cast Force, but I have a pitch. Should be fine, and then, do we want, what do we want? Which, I mean, we can put them both on top, I guess. I guess we can just put priority on top because I have six mana, right? So, oh, I can only put one on top. Is that how this works? All right, I guess it's bigger. You're the powerful three damage of attackers. Yeah, I haven't played a very tight tight stream tonight. I've F6 through a lot of things that were somewhat important. Give me the win. Let's go. All right. Okay. Collector Oof coming out of nowhere from the top ring. Submit. People forgot about Collector Oof because green decks haven't been doing very well recently, but Collector Oof is a hell of a drug against these Jewel Shops decks. Quite strong. Quite strong. No, it's not strong. This hand. Quite bad. What is going on? I wonder if this is a keep. Freeland fired? Let's go. You love to see it. I have a force in this hand, and any mana source lets me play demonic. I think I'm going to keep this hand. It's not good, but I kind of have to mulligan to a force against Jewel Shops, so mana source? Let's go. What a beautiful thing. What am I doing with this demonic, by the way? What if I just get consult? Is that like too greedy? Is that a little aggressive? I guess I could just take Black Lotus. I don't think that's good, though. If I had a green mana, I might take Oof. Whatever, I'm off it. The bird's cheering us on, so I feel good about this. I kind of want to see if I can bait a Force of Will. Because I can't protect my own combo, so. All right, baby. Fetches? Any fetches? Any fetchers? Fetch lands? Fetch lands? Oracle. Consult. GG? It's doomed. I tried my best, chat. It just wasn't good enough. Nice, we got him to board in Tormod's Grip. That card stinks. All right, Collector Roof maybe off of this. Hermit Druid Tyvar. Well, Tormod's Crypt is good against Tyvar. So unfortunately, if I keep this, Hermit Druid Tyvar was going to be good if they didn't have Tormod's Crypt. So I got smacked in the face real quick with that karma by saying Tormod's Crypt was bad because I had drew my one Tyvar. Sag. So I could go probe, birds, go untap, Tyvar, Hermit Druid. Well, there's just no good timing window, right? So if I like, if I Tyvar and then activate Hermit Druid, then the priority goes to them and they just Tormod's grip me. So. No, there's no good timing window. If I activate Hermit Druid and it all resolves, and then I activate Tyvar, that goes on the stack. They can respond to that with a Tormod's grip. If I activate Tyvar and then activate Hermit Druid, there's a stack, and they can respond to that. I'm just trying to figure out if this is good enough. Because it could be, right? Like, we're going to draw through one of these with a probe. Right. Of course. Yes. If I did not go for a druid kill, I can still minus my Tyvar. Yes, that is a true. If I hit an oracle, yes, that is a true statement. You are onto it. Yeah, you know, I'm down. It's really slow though. I don't know if I'm like just supposed to be looking for Force Odawara. I am so happy I took this line, my lord. This is like the best kind of hand to see with the line that we took where we're grinding. As long as they don't top deck Coveted Jewel. But even then, like, they're not 100% to combo off if they top deck Coveted Jewel. That's a Trinisphere. Wait, they just turned off their Force of Will. Kind of awkward. The another awkward thing now is I can't play two spells this turn. They did turn off their Force of Wills, though, so there's something here. I think for the first one, we're just going to untap this. I guess I could have untapped the Oracle, but... So, yeah. So now I can play Tyvar, and if I hit Oracle, I can respond to the Oracle trigger. You're right. We made it there. Okay, so I am going to do that. I hope this works. This would be pretty cool. All right, so I am going to play a Hermit Druid. And then I am going to go for a blind Tyvar. And try to hit an Oracle, which I did not hit Oracle. Unfortunate. Okay. Attack you. I mean, this Tormod script is protecting them from dying immediately, because we could just Hermit Druid and Oracle, but the Tormod script is protecting them, so. All right, well, now they can play Force of Will, so that's pretty annoying. That is not a good draw. We did get rid of three land drops, that is true, and then drew a fourth land drop. I think I'm just gonna... No, I think I'll wait one more turn. I don't think it's worth losing time. Like, we could die, I guess, but... Get in there. Everybody, get in there. Let's untap you. And get some manas. All right, we're going to give it another shot next turn. What is this? They draw a PO? Oh, no. Sad. That's bad for anyone counting at home. P PO was a good draw. I mean, the Grim Monolith was the big draw here. It let them play Force of Will and play PO. That was a good draw. Can't imagine we win this game from this point, but... yeah. It's doomed. Maybe I should have gone for it. How many turns did I really think I was going to get? I guess I did think my opponent had a... yeah, I should have just gone for it. Top three cards again. Citadel. Ooh. Yeah, this is sad. I thought we had a pretty decent shot after the Trinisphere went down. I don't know. I could have shuffled my Ponder. That was a big decision. Yeah, Bird can take Jewel, which is fun. Yeah, I don't know. It kind of made sense to do the take the line we chose. All right, it's doomed. Let's take a look at our top three cards, maybe. Magic Online might not let us here. One was a Hermit Druid. One was a Hermit Druid. And one was a Flusterstorm. All right, so we wouldn't have won. It wasn't a bad league, though. We'll take a 3-2 with this deck. Overall, my thoughts on this deck. It's really cool, and the interactions are sweet, and I do think that Tyvar interacts really well with Hermit Druid Oracle. I think the interaction is quite good. I just don't know if this deck has the power level to compete in 2023 Vintage. 2023 Vintage is a place full of Bazaar of Baghdad players putting in 12 free power with 3 counterspells. Jewel PO players playing turn one, kill you with force backup. So it's a powerful format of the mono white players. I actually think this deck has a really bad mono white matchup, which is quite hard to do in my mind. It's really hard to make decks in Vintage that have bad mono white matchups, but I think this one is definitely one of them. No basics, dies to removal really badly. So I'm not sure. I hope that somebody can take the Hermit Druid shell and run with it and make something that is consistently powerful, but I'm probably going to hang this deck up after this league. I did do a couple leagues before this, and I was really, really unenthused. We played against a wide variety of decks over the course of all three leagues. Like, when I played my test leagues, I played against a bunch of Wasteland decks and got my butt kicked. And then we played this set of matches here, which was mostly Jewel PO combo decks, which I think we should have a better matchup than Wasteland decks because we have so many forces and collect roofs and that things. It's nice that the colored bug gives you access to some real haymakers like Collector Roof, Force of Vigor, and blue gives you obviously Forces of Will and Negation, but I don't know. I think this one is going to get shelved as we move towards some of our other brews from one, All Will Be One Phyrexia. I've got a blue Birthing Pod deck, a different Tyvar deck using Fiend Artisan. We've got a Natural Order Show and Tell Atraxa deck. Again, I spelled Atraxa wrong. You would think I would. And there's also going to be a Spell Dancer Shredder deck that I'm pretty interested in playing. So lots of fun things down the pipeline here over the course of the next few weeks for Vintage. We have a challenge on Saturday, and we have prelims on Monday, Wednesday, Fridays that are all firing. We've fired maybe six prelims in a row at this point. So lots more Vintage content coming to you, the viewer. New videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday on my channel, 11 a.m. Eastern. I will see you then.